I'm here to discuss on this matter, which is in Raya, and I thank Mr. Selvin, who's following up this matter very much, which is we have got the khazan lands. I'm going to hazna hai tinga net gaila bamboo gan te jo oir eskun almost 3-4 meter oir net gaila ante neta ankita gail te ni ti jo sunya tai ti nuste hatali बारीक तुगे सुंगटां हातालीं आनी देखून तें बी गायलें तें सुंगटां बी गायलें तें हाय ना जाचें तें तें नेट गायलां ते नेटान सुणी सुणी जो आमगेली थोडी जो सुणी जो म्हूण जायत वयताय ती सगळीं त्या नेटान पोसताय आनी जे जो जे जो हजनकार आहा तो तांकां काडटा पूण जायत पाटी तें काण आसून तशीं उरताय आनी ती मोत्ताय.
सी रायट बिहायंड मी यू कॅन सी लॉट ऑफ नेट्स बींग इरेक्टेड बाय दीस khazan land people who have won the bid for the fishing season. So what they have done is they have erected nets not to do anything with the fish or fish harvesting. It is done to prevent the birds from eating their prey, that is the fish. So in a day you can see around 5 to 10 birds being entangled in the nets, and there is no rescue for them. They just die, and by looking at them the other birds come and they get entangled and they die. So they have a lot of varieties of birds which are being killed in this way, like kites, like fish eating eagles. So this is a clear violation of wildlife. Same thing like how there is a violation of wildlife when we say it is a killing of frogs. So these people who have erected the nets has to be penalized in the same way, with the same act, like how we do for the wildlife, that is the killing of frogs, and because this is related to wildlife. And the people who are to be penalized is the tenant association of this area and the person who have won the bid. Why the tenant association has to be done? Because so that if somebody else wins the bid next time, they will not be able to put the nets around like this.